Chairman Murkowski. I look forward to today's hearing about ocean energy. It's been quite a while since West Virginia's had oceanfront property, but I'm told it did happen. But I want to thank you for convening the hearing on emerging ocean technologies. As a boat owner and an avid boater, as all my colleagues in the Senate know, I take a special interest in the fuels part of today's conversation, which I think will be most interesting. I appreciate our witnesses joining us to share your expertise with us and update us on the progress made in the technologies and the deployment of these technologies. I'd like to take a moment to note the relevance of this topic to the work that Chairman Murkowski, the members of this committee, and that I have undertaken to advance the American Energy Innovation Act, which we're very hopeful that we are still be successful very shortly. Our energy package will advance climate solutions across the four sectors of the economy that make up approximately 90% of our current greenhouse gas emissions. Advancing marine renewable energy and offshore wind technologies is part of that solution, as well as authorizing much needed research on the industrial equipment needed to make the shipping fuels of the future. Included in that package are Senator Smith and Collins' Wind Energy Research and Development Act, which covers both onshore and offshore wind energy research and development, and Senator Wyden's Marine Energy Research and Development Act, which covers the full range of marine energy technologies. Those are just two examples of the important provisions in the energy bill, and I remain committed to working to help get that across the line with my chairman. Turning to the topic at hand, I'm glad that for today's hearing, we have both the perspective of the technology and project developers, including DOE's important research, development, and demonstration role, and also the agency charged with managing the federal permitting approval process, the Bureau of Ocean Energy Management. That's important because we need increasing and continued R&D for these growing and emerging technologies, but we also need to ensure that they can actually come online. So I look forward to hearing from our witnesses about some of the barriers for these technologies, and I expect that we will hear a robust discussion of how we can better align in our national interest in developing these new energy sources and the industries behind them with reality of the permitting challenges that you're going to face. My good friend, Senator Whitehouse, joined us just last week to discuss his work on offshore wind, specifically relating to revenue sharing. Revenue sharing is a big thing with most every senator here because it's trying to basically support their home areas. Revenue sharing is not the topic of today, but I'd be remiss not to mention that expanding offshore generation in federal waters is a revenue raiser. In addition, the technologies that we will be discussing today have the potential to create U.S. jobs for workers in communities that need a long-term lifeline. Our supply chains and manufacturing sector have struggled for decades, causing hardship for steel workers, shipbuilders, coal miners, and many other hardworking men and women around the country. The coronavirus has put those vulnerabilities in the spotlight and is making it clear how important targeted and enduring policies to correct those vulnerabilities will be. By identifying the policies and industries that will rebuild our manufacturing sector and reclaim our economic future, I believe that we can help our workers and their families while reestablishing U.S. leadership in existing and entirely new energy markets. One final quick fact that I'd like to share is that maritime freight shipping currently contributes approximately 12% of the U.S. greenhouse gas emissions. That's 12% by the shipping. Slightly more than our agricultural sector, and shipping business is projected to triple in the next 30 years. I know that DOE is hard at work to help us meet the International Maritime Organization's reduced emissions goals, and so I look forward to hearing about the research and development needs and opportunities for low-carbon maritime fuels. With that, I appreciate all of you being here and those who are joining us virtually, and look forward to the hearing. Thank you, Madam Chairman.